In our earlier modules, we have already talked in detail about the partition function and its significance. We know that partition function is the most important quantity in statistical mechanics, and it is also called the storehouse of information, because all the thermodynamic properties are the properties of the bulk matter are ultimately related to partition function. And if we know partition function, all these properties can be calculated. We also saw in the last module how entropy is related to the partition function. We derived the equation which comes to be S is equal to KB n ln Q plus E by T. This is the equation which connects entropy with the partition function Q of the particle. In our modules today, we will talk about the relationship between the partition function and the thermodynamic properties in detail. We have already understood that if we have a system containing n particles and having the total energy E at a particular temperature, and we are assuming that the system is obeying Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, then we know that E can be related as summation I n I epsilon I. This is equation 2. Then equation 3 is that the total number of particles n is equal to summation I n I. Here you already know the meanings of n I and epsilon I. And we also know that the general relation for the partition function of a particle constituting the system is given by Q is equal to summation I g I e to the power beta epsilon I. Here we know that g I is the degeneracy associated with the ith energy level. We also know that for a system obeying Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, thermodynamic probability W is given by the relation n factorial pi I g I raised to the power n I divided by n I factorial. And according to the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution law, this W will correspond to the maximum or the most probable macro state if n I is given by n I is equal to n divided by Q g I e to the power beta epsilon I. In the last module, we also showed that this beta is equal to minus 1 upon k b t. With all these equations which we have already done, now we will move to deriving the relationship between thermodynamic properties and the partition function. The first property which we now take is the total energy E of the system. We know from equation 2 that we get E is equal to summation I n upon Q g I e to the power minus epsilon I by k b t into epsilon I. So, this is what we now get. Now, if we differentiate the equation giving the general expression for the partition function, that is the equation 4, with respect to temperature, we get delta Q by delta T is equal to summation I g I e to the power minus epsilon I k b by T, then multiplication epsilon I divided by k b t square. This is the equation 9, and this is coming by differentiating equation 4 with respect to temperature. You can do this derivation yourself also. Now, if we rearrange equation 9, we can see that k b t square, if we take it to the left hand side, it becomes k b t square del Q by del T is equal to summation I g I e to the power minus epsilon I k b by T, and then multiplied by epsilon I. That is the equation 10. Now, this expression or this equation 10, if we substitute in our equation 8, which we earlier wrote, we get now E is equal to N upon Q KB T square del Q by del T. That is the equation 11. And if Q is taken in differential, then it will becomes E is equal to N KB T square del ln Q by del T. That is the equation 12, and that gives us the equation for the total energy E of the system. Please keep it in mind, N is the total number of particles of the system, KB is the Boltzmann constant, T is the temperature, and Q is the partition function of the particle at a temperature T. One thing which you can very well understand is that if the number of the particles in the system is equal to Avogadro's number, then NKB will become R, that is the gas constant, and the energy expression reduces to E is equal to RT square del ln Q by del T. So, this is the expression which gives the total energy E of the system per mole at a particular temperature in terms of the partition function. After this, now we come to another thermodynamic property, which is entropy. And let us see how entropy is related to partition function and E. We have already done it in the last module that the entropy is given by KBN ln Q plus E by T. Now, if in this equation we substitute the energy expression in terms of partition function, we get the equation number 14, that is S is equal to KBN ln Q plus NKB T square del ln Q by del T. So, that is the expression for the entropy of the system. Likewise, we can go to another thermodynamic property, that is enthalpy. And enthalpy normally in thermodynamics is expressed as H is equal to E plus PV. Now, if we substitute here the energy expression for E, we get H is equal to NKB T square del ln Q by del T plus PV. And that is the expression for the enthalpy of this system. Coming to Helmholtz free energy A, in thermodynamics, this is expressed as A is equal to E minus Ts. Now, what we have to do is we have to just substitute the values or the energy expression and the expression for entropy in this equation 17. If we do that, we get A is equal to NKB T square del ln Q by del T minus TKBN ln Q plus NKB T square del ln Q by del T. That is the equation 18. And now you can see the first and the last third term in on the right hand side, they cancel, and we get ultimately A is equal to minus NKB T ln Q. So, this is a very simple equation which gives us the expression for Helmholtz free energy. Likewise, for Gibbs free energy, which is a very important quantity in thermodynamics, one can say that Gibbs free energy, which normally is expressed as H minus Ts, and H can be written as E plus PV. So, G becomes equal to A plus PV, and therefore, if we substitute the expressions for Helmholtz free energy from equation 19 and we also substitute the PV, then we get G is equal to minus N KB T ln Q plus PV. So, this is the equation which gives the relationship between the partition function and the Gibbs free energy. So, now you have seen that how partition function is related to the various thermodynamic quantities. And these expressions, whatsoever we have derived, these will be of immense use later on. After having done all this, now we will move to the next step. And next step is how to calculate the various thermodynamic properties for a system. Now, ultimately, the properties which we have to calculate, that depend upon the partition function. So, first question will come, how to write the partition function of a particle constituting the system. We will discuss now how all these properties can be calculated for a chemical system. So, how to do that? First thing which we will have to keep in mind is that suppose there is a system containing n particles. Then in that system, one will have to see whether the particle is monoatomic or polyatomic. Because depending upon whether it is monoatomic or diatomic or triatomic, partition function will change, and then accordingly the corresponding values of the thermodynamic properties will also be different. So, the most important thing which we have to see is, if the particle is monoatomic, that means only one atom per particle, or if it is a polyatomic, that means more than one atoms if we have. First, we take the particles which are monoatomic, and suppose we take a chemical system, let it be helium or neon or any other inert gas, all these are monoatomic. Now, for such systems, since they are only monoatomic, the only energy which these particles can have is the translational energy. That means, for monoatomic chemical systems, only translational energy is possible. And therefore, the partition function which will be possible for this monoatomic system will be translational partition function. That means, Q will be equal to QT, but translational motion in space can be along three directions, x, y and z, and these three are quite independent of each other. Therefore, the total translational partition function for a monoatomic system can be taken to be equal to the product of QTx, QTy and QTz. QTx is the partition function which is the translational one along x direction. QTy is the translational partition function along y direction, and QTz is the translational partition function along z direction. So, that is very, very simple. That means, for a monoatomic system, only 3 degrees of freedom are possible, and those 3 are translational along x, y and z, and from them one can calculate the partition function which is only translational one. Now, we move to the next complex system. Suppose we have a polyatomic system, and suppose first of all we take a diatomic system. The diatomic system would always be linear. Therefore, for such a system, there are 2 atoms per particle, then the total degrees of freedom, as you know, will be 6. And out of these 6 degrees of freedom, 3 will be translational. Those will be along x, y and z direction. 2 will be rotational. So, diatomic molecule, which of course will always be linear. Therefore, it will have 2 rotational degrees of freedom, and remaining 1 degree will be the vibrational one. On the other hand, if the particle is triatomic or more than 2 atoms, suppose we have, then in that case, total degrees of freedom will be, say, for a triatomic, it will be 9, then 3 will be translational, and if the triatomic is nonlinear, it will have 3 rotational. If it is linear, it will have 2 rotational, and the remaining degrees, whether it is 3 or 4, those will be the vibrational one. So, one can say that if the particle constituting the system is polyatomic, then in that case the total partition function is the product of translational, rotational and vibrational partition functions. Number of degrees ultimately will depend upon how many atoms are there in the particle and whether the particle is linear or non-linear. Now, we will go into the details of the partition function of a monoatomic particle. Suppose it is a monoatomic particle, then in that case, as we have already discussed, there will be 3 degrees of freedom and all the 3 degrees of freedom would be translational. And therefore, the partition function will be the product of the partition functions along x, y and z directions. That means, q will be equal to q t, that means, will be equal to q t x, q t y and q t z. So, once we have this, since we know the general expression for the partition function, we have already done it. Putting that, one can say that the total partition function q t will be equal to summation I g t I e to the power minus epsilon t I upon k b t. That is basically the general expression for the partition function. And if we now put degeneracies, total translational degeneracies will be the product of the degeneracies along x, y and z direction, and the total energy, as you can see in this expression, will be epsilon t x, then epsilon t y and epsilon t z. Therefore, the partition function q t will be equal to summation I g t x, g t y, g t z, these are the product of the 3 degeneracies, multiplied by e to the power minus epsilon t x plus epsilon t y plus epsilon t z divided by k b t. And this is the equation number 25th, which gives us the total partition function, which is the translational one. Now, if we really have to calculate the expression for the translational partition function, we will need to put the degeneracies, if it is there, and also put the corresponding expressions for the energy in this and then take its summation. So, that will be the calculation of the partition function, that means the calculation of the translational partition function. And if we have to do it, ultimately the equation 25th will split into 3 equations, as you can see here. The first part is representing the translational component along x direction. The second part is representing the translational component along y direction, and the third is along the z direction. As now we will see later on in the next module, we will put the expressions for the energy which we get from quantum mechanics as the input in these expressions and then solve them and get the ultimately expression for the total translational partition function. So, in this module today, we have discussed that if we know the partition function of a particle constituting a system, then in that case, knowing that, one can calculate the properties of the system. That means, the thermodynamic properties. We derived the various expressions and we showed that total energy E comes to be equal to n k b t square del l n q by del t. Then entropy was shown to be equal to k b n l n q plus n k b t del l n q by del t. And enthalpy H is equal to n k b t square del l n q by del t plus p v. And A is equal to minus n k b t l n q, and the Gibbs free energy is equal to minus n k b t l n q plus p v. But please remember here that here q is the partition function of the particle constituting the system. This is something which you must keep it in mind, because later on we will also be talking about the partition function of the system as a whole. That of course will be related to Q, but that we will denote later on by capital Q. We will do that later on. Besides that, we also discussed in this module that if we have to study any chemical system using statistical mechanics, we need to calculate the partition function, and for calculating the partition function, we have to understand whether the particle constituting the system is monoatomic or polyatomic. We said that if it is monoatomic, then it has translational motion only, it will have 3 translational degrees of freedom, and therefore the entire partition function will be translational partition function. And this was shown to split into Q 3 x directions, x, y and z. We showed that Q is equal to Q t is equal to Q t x, Q t y and Q t z. And for polyatomic systems, we said that we will have to take into account, besides translational, also the contributions from rotational and the vibrational motions. And how many rotational and vibrational degrees of freedom would be there in a polyatomic system? That will depend upon whether the system is linear or non-linear. If the particle is linear, then rotational degrees of freedom would be 2. If it is non-linear, these would be 3, and then of course the remaining would be the vibrational degrees of freedom. So all these details we have learnt today, and we will continue with our discussion with how to calculate the expression for the translational partition function in our next module.